He looked pretty bad on his last fight, in my opinion.
How did the fight end?
Oh, he won.
Okay.
He won. He didn't look good.
Sure, not going to Twitter,
huh? Well, you got to give it to Ali. He's loyal. That's it.
Oh, loyal.
Hey, we're here. I'm keeping it 100.
I don't know why people... Ali had Brandon winning the first four rounds when he fought Acosta.
And he did win. And he won by knockout.
He knocked him out.
He's loyal.
He knocked him out in the 11th.
But
he had him winning the first four rounds.
It's true. But we just said Max Kellerman did it on HBO.
Yeah, he did on
the ESPN guys do it on ESPN. The Zone do it on the Zone. So ESPN could do it on ESPN. On EsNews. Sorry.
Yeah, you're right. Do that, yeah.
Mosley versus Loma at 135.
That's just nothing we'll ever see, but Mosley would have beat him. Mosley was too good at 135.
He was like 35-0 with 32
Mosley
knockouts.
Mosley was fucking badass at 135.
He was fast.
Oh, yeah, Mosley would have beat Loma at 135. But, you know.
It's hypothetical,
why
yeah.
Why even talk about that shit?
Loma's one of the best in the world right now. And Ring Magazine have him number 2 pound for pound after Canelo. Yeah, number 3, Crawford.
Those are the top 3, I think.
But I have a question for you, Robert. I looked at the Ring Magazine ratings. When they're ranked 147 division, they have Spence 1, Crawford 2. On the pound-for-pound list, they have Crawford, then Spence. How could that be? How could you be number one in your division?
Well, because maybe the division probably... Well, I can't say because of the opponents, because Crawford... I mean, Spence hasn't really fought big names at 147 either. So...
Well, he fought Sean Porter and Mikey.
Sean Porter and Mikey. But,
and Kell Brook.
You're right. So maybe because of that, I don't know.
But pound for pound, they have Crawford a hell of a
I do put Crawford on top of Spence, I think, right now. With Crawford's performances, you know, he fights, right? He's patient, and then when he wants to pick it up, he just switches modes and goes for the kill. Crawford's a real deal. It's a cool dude, too.
What does he do next, Robert? Is it Bisputin? Is it?
Well, I don't know, because I don't know if Bisputin has a mandatory. I think Bisputin has a mandatory, from what I've heard, Bisputin has a mandatory against that Cuban. That Cuban 147, fought Sean Porter. A lot of people thought he beat Sean Porter.
Oh, Ugas?
Ugas.
Oh, that's a great fight. Ugas is a real tough
that's
fighter,
what
Robert.
From what I've heard,
yeah.
I think he's got a mandatory.
That's a tough
but
fight.
But if not, I think Bisputin versus Crawford will happen. Crawford, I don't know who else he's got right there at 147 through top rank that could make the fight. But Jose will be there next year. This year, we're going to try to do those two or three fights for Jose.
Unify.
And obviously unify him. Jose wants to unify against Josh Taylor. Jose also has one more mandatory against the WBO. So I think it's these three fights that we're planning for Jose, and maybe next year go to 147.
That would be huge.
Yeah.
And then 147, Jose would be, first he has to take care of business
with
Posol, then Josh Taylor, and then...
We're thinking, you know, obviously Taylor and all that, but fuck, Posol is training like a motherfucker, and Posol is the real deal.
Yeah.
So we can't just look past
former Postol. Champion, and fought the biggest names.
Yeah, we can't look past Posol.
And he beat Matisse.
Yeah.